Reverse diabetes with beta cell regeneration. This video is based on research conducted at Baker Heart and Diabetes Institute in Melbourne, Australia. This video will be important to type 2 diabetes persons as well. Type 2 people also find that, after few years, they need more and more medications and insulin. Nobody knows why it is happening. I think their beta cells also get damaged due to a similar reason to type 1. But at a slower rate. Always consult your healthcare professional before making any changes to your medication or lifestyle. Even though I was classified as a type 2 diabetic, my insulin production has dropped significantly to equal of a type 1 person. I have several videos on this subject on the YouTube channel. One is about a blood pressure medication drug that shows promise in restoring in people with type 1 in the early months or years. So, I am interested in this type of research, as I need to find a way to at least protect my beta cells from damage. A recent study conducted by Marikar at the Baker Heart and Diabetes Institute, featured in Clinical Epigenetics, illustrates the potential of drugs to activate pancreatic progenitor cells, transforming them into insulin-producing beta-like cells by inhibiting the EZH2 enzyme. In cases of type 1 diabetes, damage to beta cells leads to insufficient insulin production by the pancreas. This results in elevated glucose levels in the bloodstream, causing hyperglycemia and preventing the utilization of glucose for energy. Extensive research has focused on alternative approaches like cell replacement therapy and pancreas transplantation. However, the scarcity of donor organs limits the viability of the latter. The study explores the regenerative capabilities of pancreatic cells, examining the stimulation of ductal stem cells with small molecule inhibitors as an alternative method to restore insulin production for diabetes patients. While we are in the middle of the video, do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe. See the description and comments for references and abbreviations. We would appreciate your comments. The drugs utilized in the research encompass a synthetically designed drug mainly employed in cancer therapy due to its association with EZH2 overexpression in cancers, and a naturally derived drug previously tested for inflammatory conditions. Monash University's PhD student, Safiya Naina Marikar, affiliated with Professor Sam L. Oster's Human Epigenetics Program at the Baker Institute, notes that the study indicates reprogrammed cells exhibit the ability to produce insulin and crucial functionalities like responding to glucose stimulation with insulin secretion. Professor L. Oster emphasizes the significance of this groundbreaking epigenetics research led by early career scientists, foreseeing potential improvements in the lives of individuals with diabetes in the future. While additional studies are required to explain the mechanism and identity of cell targets, these findings present a promising avenue for beta cell regeneration. This could serve as a viable alternative to islet transplantation, potentially bridging the therapeutic gap for those grappling with insulin-dependent diabetes. Think, your health is very important for your family as well. Do not forget to click the like button and subscribe. Thanks very much for watching this video. Up above you see a video related to health. It will be more helpful to you and your family. Subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video.